welcome to worship at the Free Methodist Church. We're glad you're here. It's great to be together, to connect to our living God, and to worship Him together. We're here on Sunday, Thanksgiving Sunday, the Sunday before Thanksgiving, and of course we are very full of thanks as we worship our God, and it is also on the church calendar, Christ the King Sunday. And those two go very well together. As we give God thanks, we give God thanks that He is King over all the earth. And now more than ever, we want to recognize Christ, our living King. And so as we do so, let us hear the words of Psalm 47, 1 to 9. Clap your hands, O you people. Shout joyfully to God with a joyous shout, because the Lord Most High is awesome. He is the great King of the whole world. He subdues the nations under us, subdues all people beneath our feet. He chooses our inheritance for us, the heights of Jacob, which He loves. God has gone up with a joyous shout, the Lord with the blast of the ram's horn. Sing praises to God. Sing praises to our King. Sing praises because God is King of the whole world. Sing praises with a song of instruction. God is King over the nations. God sits on His holy throne. The leaders of all people are gathered with the people of Abraham's God, because the earth's guardians belong to God. God is exalted beyond all. Let's worship the Lord together.
Oh, Amen. Father, we rejoice in you today. We come to you with great thankfulness and gratitude for who you are and who you continue to be in our lives every day. This has been such a difficult season for so many people for so many different reasons, but today we rejoice that you are with us and that you love us and that you continue to be in control throughout all of eternity. So the same yesterday, today, and forever. And we love you, Lord. Thank you for being here. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Today we're happy to have another one of our youth share his Psalm 23 makeover. Peter Moshito will be sharing Psalm 23 using a different metaphor, but keeping the same number of lines and the rhythm of the psalm. Let's listen to this together.
Hi, FM Church. My name is Peter Moshito, and today I'm going to share with you my Psalm 23 rewrite. The Lord is my coach. I don't need anyone else. He makes me relax on the sidelines. He leads me beneath shaded dugouts. He renews my soul. He guides me through split-second decisions, for he is God. Even if I lose the game, I won't hang my head in defeat, for God is always with me. Your encouragement and your guidance, they lessen my stress. You nourish me with peace in the presence of the opposing team. You honor me like an MVP. I am overjoyed. Surely your goodness and love will follow me through all 9 innings of the game, and I will trust in God forever. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. We have a few announcements for you today. As always, we would love to connect with you, especially if this is your first time seeing our home church video. We would love to get to know you. And if you would like to hear more about the church, you can reach out to a pastor or fill out an online connection card. And we would love to take you out to get coffee and just to get to know you a little bit better. There are many ways that we love to connect throughout the week. We just want to remind you about our midday prayer that's still going on every weekday, and that's just a great opportunity to pause your day and come pray with a pastor. A different pastor will be on each weekday, and so we invite you to join that. That's at 11:30 on Zoom. And apart from this home church video, we have a few Sunday gatherings. We have our Under the Tent service at 9:30 in our upper parking lot. And so if you would ever like to join that, you can just look at our website and RSVP, and we would love to have you there in person. In addition, we have our online prayer and share time at 10:45 on Zoom. Since for home church, we can't have a praises and prayer request time in our service, this is a time for that. So we invite you to join and pray with one another on there. For our ways to help this week, we want to highlight SB Act. SB Act helps to lead collaborative efforts to support crisis responses. They serve immigrants, people without homes, and West Side residents in our community as well. If you'd like to learn more about what this organization is doing in our community, you can look at their website, sbact.org, and also the link for that is on our news and events page of our website as well. Typically during this time of year, we have our missions marketplace set up in our upper room. We have a ton of vendors, people selling goods, and this is a great way to get Christmas gifts for friends and family. But obviously we can't do that this year, but we still want to provide a way for you to shop those organizations online. Each week we're going to be putting information about this in the newsletter, which will give you a link to a page that has all the different websites, all the different organizations, and also ways that you can support our missionaries, their projects, and Free Methodist partner organizations as well. If you miss it in our newsletter, you can always look at it on our website, fmcsb.org/events. Lastly, I just want to remind you of a really fun opportunity to make your own Advent wreaths during the season of Advent. We have assembled all the materials and gathered all the materials for you. We're going to be putting those into kits, and we invite you to come by the church and pick those up. It's just a fun thing to do with your family. You can put those together and then light the candles along with us during the season of Advent and the weeks leading up to Christmas. If you would like to reserve a wreath to make sure that you get one, you can email me at maddie@fmcsb.org and I'll put your name on the list. Otherwise, it's first come, first served. And there also is a $5 donation that we would greatly appreciate if you are able to do that. For our giving moment today, we're going to have a time of Thanksgiving, and we're going to hear from many of you who have sent us your Thanksgiving videos. As we listen to all of these, let us just be reminded of the many ways that the Lord has blessed us, and let us remember to give our thanks to Him.
Hi, it's Aaliyah Sheps, sophomore at Westmont College, calling in from my dorm room. This Thanksgiving season, I'm so grateful for my family, my parents and my sister back home, and my brother and his wife, who will be welcoming a new baby boy into the world next week. Grateful for those old generations and the new generations. Happy Thanksgiving.
Hi, I'm Becky.
And I'm Doug.
And we're the Castlemans. And we really want to thank God for being in our lives every minute of every day.
And we're also thankful for our health.
So we just want to say,
Happy Thanksgiving!
Hello, I'm Suzette McCormick. During the season of Thanksgiving, I want to give thanks for my children, my mother, for my family, my extended family, my cousins whom I've been Zooming with since we're in this time of COVID and we're not able to meet together. I've been getting to know them more and more. I am so grateful for new beginnings and for health. I am so also very thankful for the love of Christ and his mercy. Enjoy this season.
Good morning, church family. My name is Chris Breslin.
And my name is Louis.
I'm thankful that during this difficult time that I know that God is in control. He showers us with grace, love, and mercy.
And I'm thankful for Chris, the beautiful love of my life. Chris brought me to our church family, and I'm thankful for the joy of worshiping our Lord through music.
Hello, everyone. My name is Stephanie Kan. And in this season of giving thanks, I'm so thankful for my family who take care of me and love me in all the ways. I'm so thankful that they are close and that we can spend such great time together. I am thankful for my friends who are a pillar of strength and love in my life. And even though physically it's not the same, there's so much love. And it transcends beyond just the physicality of it all. I am thankful for my job, and I'm thankful for all of you, my church family. Though we are far from each other, we are close in spirit and in love, and I can truly feel God's love in my life as I'm reminded of all the wonderful things to be thankful for. I can't wait to see you all, and happy Thanksgiving.
Hi, we're the Taylors, and I'm thankful for family.
I'm thankful for all the gifts that people give us, and I'm also thankful for Ren here's sense of humor. Ouch.
This is Grace, and she is thankful for the sun and for flowers.
So we are going to be moving soon, right around Christmas time. We've been so thankful for the Free Methodist Church family and for our time here in Santa Barbara. Really sad to be saying goodbye, but really thankful for all of you. Thanks for making this time here so special.
We love you. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Chloe, and this is Erin. And this Thanksgiving, I'm really excited to be back in California. A couple of months ago, Erin and I were talking. We were living out of state, and he had gone to seminary, and I just told him that it was really important to be able to be in California for the holidays, and we started praying about it. We didn't know how it was going to work out, and so it just feels like God really made a way for us, and it was just really cool to see how he worked to bring that desire to fruition and for us to be here. It feels really special to be with our church family, and just to have that dream kind of come to reality.
Yeah, I'm really thankful that God has made a way, that he said that he's going to prepare a place for us, and he did. And it's something that we didn't totally imagine, but as always with God, it's always better than you can imagine in that moment at that time. And so we're happy to be with the community of the Free Methodist Church. We're happy to have access to family and friends, like as we weren't out of state, so we're happy to go into the holidays in that way. So
Hello everyone. This Thanksgiving season, I am more than ever grateful for the things I've long considered basics in life: a quiet place to live, a job, phone calls and FaceTimes with family and friends, and the joy of going for a run.
Hi, we are Diana, Selma, and Josue Morales, and I'm thankful for my family and for God's love, for being healthy, and for all the friends and family that have blessed us over the year.
I am thankful for my family.
I am thankful for my house.
We are also thankful for all our friends in the community of the Free Methodist Church for all the support and love they've given us over the years.
In our live services, we had a moment called Ministry in Music, and this was a song or a piece that was just for enjoyment and reflection and prayer. So we're going to do that in celebration of Thanksgiving this week. Me, Amanda, and Sarah are going to sing an acoustic arrangement of How Great Thou Art. So we invite you to just sit back and reflect.
My God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great!
God, how great you are.
soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Good morning, FM kids. Happy Sunday. We're counting down the days to Thanksgiving. I'm excited, and I hope you are too. I know a lot of you kids like to play music. Maybe you play an instrument, or maybe you just like to listen to music. And I was thinking, on Thanksgiving, you know what a musician's favorite part of the meal is? The drumsticks, right? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. You can tell that one to your friends and family at Thanksgiving. Now, Pastor Colleen's going to be talking today in our sermon about 10 people who were healed by Jesus. And out of those 10, only one person went back to thank Jesus. The other 9 ran away excited and happy and healed, but didn't thank Jesus. And I was thinking that in my life, there might be times where I forget to give thanks. Not because I'm ungrateful, but because sometimes I don't remember all of the things that I could give thanks for. So what I wanted to do this week was I wanted to give you 5 things that you could give thanks for, and it's easy to remember if you hold up your hand. So here are 5 things that you can give thanks for. Maybe you and your family can give thanks for this week. The first thing, by the thumb there, is to give thanks for those people who are closest to you. Your mother, your father, your brothers and sisters, your pets. Don't forget the pets. Anybody who's close to you, you can give thanks for them. Second, you can give thanks to God. That's the index finger pointing up to God. You can give thanks for who He is. You can give thanks for what He's made. We live in a beautiful city here in Santa Barbara, and we have so much amazing nature. And you can give thanks to God for who He is and what He's made. Third, we have the tallest finger, and that's for people who lead us. Well, if you're in school, you can give thanks for your teachers. You can give thanks for the principal of your school. Maybe you play a sport and you can give thanks for a coach. Anybody who leads you in anything, you can give thanks for them. Now, this fourth finger here is actually the weakest finger in our hand. I don't know if you know that, but that's the weakest finger we have. And so we can give thanks for the people in our life who may be sick. We can give thanks when God does heal them. We can give thanks that even when people in our lives are sick, maybe even when you've been sick, that God is still with us. And then the last finger, the pinky, that's furthest away from me. That's to give thanks for the people that are furthest away from us. Maybe you have friends or family members who are far away, and maybe some of them you can't see this year in Thanksgiving because we're trying to be safe in the middle of this virus. Maybe we give thanks for our missionaries, who are people who are serving all the way around the world to help people know Jesus, but they're far away from us, but close to us in our hearts. So this week, as you go into Thanksgiving, I want you to remember to be thankful for so many things, for so many people in your life. And if you've got a hand, you can remember those 5 things: people who are closest to us, God and what He's made, people who lead us in some way or another, people who are sick or maybe who've been healed, and then people who are furthest away. I am thankful for you, FM kids, and I hope you have a great week, that you have a great time with your family, that you stay safe, and have a great week. Eat lots of drumsticks.
Let's bow down and pray together. Holy and merciful God, we have come to worship you just as we are in this time of a prolonged crisis and Thanksgiving. Lord, we recognize that many things in our society and nation are not the way they should be. The COVID cases skyrocketing, hospitals almost in full capacity in many parts of our nation, and the COVID patients continuing to die in this state of national tragedy and indifference from the government. Have mercy on those affected by the COVID and all those who are suffering from sickness in silence and isolation. May your healing power be upon them. Comfort them with your peace that passes understanding and grant them patience during this frightening season. Have mercy on healthcare professionals who are valiantly and sacrificially fighting against this virus on the front line. May your strength, hope, and peace be with them. Sustain all workers and business owners who suffer unimaginable loss of livelihood due to shutdowns, quarantines, and other restrictions. And protect and guard all those who must travel for Thanksgiving holidays. Guide the leaders of our nation with wisdom and discernment so that they may provide a helpful pathway to control and overcome this virus. Grant us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may practice social distancing responsibly and lovingly. In the midst of all these challenging circumstances, however, we do count your manifold blessings and give you praise for your enduring faithfulness in our lives. In this Thanksgiving, we are grateful for our friends and family with whom we can celebrate our joys and successes, and for those close to us who support us in our times of need. May your presence and solace be with those who are lonely and brokenhearted. We give you thanks for our church community that boldly shares and embodies the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, in season and out of season. May your love and peace shine through each member of our church. Lord, we are also grateful for the promising news of developing a vaccine. Inspire and empower all the researchers who are working toward the common good. Furthermore, we give you thanks for those who are working for justice and equity for the marginalized groups in our society, the poor, the refugees, the migrants, just to name a few. Bless the works of their hands and let their voices be heard. We praise you for your spirit who guides us into all truth and gives us strength and hope for yet another day. More than anything, we are thankful for the promise and assurance of salvation given through your Son, our Lord. Through him, when all is completed, there will be no more tears, sickness, or pain. We pray all this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Join us for our Thanksgiving prayer litany.
This prayer litany is inspired by Exodus 33, 12 through 23. I will read the pastor parts and Pastor Nikki will read the people parts, so we invite you to read along with her. Your goodness, loving God, is universal, and we glimpse the fringes of your glory passing by through all our days, in the beauty of the moonlight, in the roaring of the sea, in the grandeur of mountains, in the howl of the storm, and in the gentle crashing of the waves, we see your glory passing by.
All thanks to you, creating and redeeming God.
In the smiles of friends and the tears of a loved one, in the wisdom of great intellects and the play of young children, in the energy of youth and the serenity of old age, we see your glory passing by.
All thanks to you, creating and redeeming God.
In the words of Moses, in the loving care of Ruth, in the poetry of David, and in the prophetic words of Amos, in the faith of Elizabeth and the courage of John the Baptist, we see your glory passing by. In the pregnancy of Mary, in the faithfulness of Joseph, in the birth at Bethlehem and the ministry in Galilee, in the mercy of the cross and the powerlessness of the grave, we see your glory passing by.
All thanks to you, creating and redeeming God.
In the gathering of two or three, in the large congregations, in the songs of joy and the love of the neighbor, in the struggle for justice, and in the body and the blood, we see your glory passing by.
All thanks to you, creating and redeeming God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, all thanks to you. Through all time and eternity, all thanks is yours forever.
We study a passage from Luke 17, from which I will then give a short homily about our relationship with Christ the King. Luke 17, beginning at verse 11, going through verse 19. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus! Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9? Where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." I want to be the one who turns around to say thank you. Whenever I read this story in my mind, I am that person. The one who runs back gladly to offer praise for being healed. But would I have? We often put ourselves as the protagonist of every story, the hero, the one who would have done the right thing. But would I have stopped my hooping and hollering with my friends to go and say thank you? I want to be that person. But when I think about how many times I have distinctly not been that person, it gives me pause. when I have been given a huge reprieve from Jesus, or the Lord has helped me with something difficult, or given me a gift directly from His hand. Sometimes it hasn't been until much later that I've remembered how I forgot to give praise, how I neglected to say thank you to the perfect and gracious and mighty God who is mindful of me as His lowly servant and of my circumstances, enough to make things better for me. This situation arose out of prayer. As Jesus passes by, they yell to Him and ask Him to help them, yelling their requests from a distance because they are in a quarantine bubble together, aren't they? They can't come close because they don't want Him to catch what they have. They are respectful of others, but so desperate to be helped. So they take a chance. How many times has God answered my prayer for something, and then I just keep going, happily skipping away to the next phase of what's next because I got what I asked for, not thinking to stop and say thank you? Why? Do I expect it as my due because I prayed for it? This is Christ the King Sunday, where the church celebrates Jesus as our true sovereign. This group makes a request and He grants it. I'm unsure if they knew that He was the King, but they do call Him Master. They're almost lying in wait for Him. How else could they have known He was going to come by or what He would look like? The one who said thank you is culturally not even part of His realm. And Jesus asks, why is it that a foreigner is thanking me when those who are part of the family aren't? Where are the other nine? He says. This sounds like how we can take our parents for granted. Do we not say thank you because they should already know? Because we expect our parents to help us and they don't need our thanks? Let's think about the nature of appreciation. There is an obligatory thanks we can give, and there is the kind that just comes bubbling out of our hearts that we cannot fake. This week we have an insightful quote from Pastor Tim Keller on the bulletin that says this: it's one thing to be grateful, it's another to give thanks. Gratitude is what you feel. Thanksgiving is what you do. This guy falls on the ground in honor of Jesus, in thanksgiving to Him for being healed. I always think about the part of this scripture where it says, as they went, they were made clean. Jesus tells them to go to the priest so that they can be certified as healed. And in this act of trust, in this act of going, their skin turns from being diseased and white as snow and scaly and awful to being completely new. And this guy notices and runs back and falls at Jesus' feet, praising God in a loud voice. Maybe the primal, guttural kind that would make us uncomfortable if we were there to witness it. What does our thanks look like? How often do we feel truly, truly, profoundly, humbly grateful in the everyday and the extraordinary actions of God in our lives? This man shows his heart. It took a lot of guts for them to ask Jesus to heal them, and it takes a lot of vulnerability for him to come back and fall at the Lord's feet in thanks. We wonder if the other ones aren't grateful. Is it better not to say it if we don't feel it? No, that isn't right. We should always say thank you. Is it weird that the other nine don't follow suit when they see the other guy go back? They couldn't have been that far away. I always think in my mind when I read this, they were right there. It would have been natural for them to say, oh, yeah, wow, thanks, Jesus. Yet they must have been far enough away that the Lord asks where they are. There's a thought here about people receiving an amazing gift and the magnitude of what has been given overshadows the giver, the one who gave the gift. What we want so badly keeps us focused on how our bad fortunes have turned to good. Not only have their bodies been restored, but they get to go home to their families and their community. They're able to rejoin back into life. Also, they are witnesses of a major miracle of 10 people being healed all at once. Just like that. Amazing. Do they not come back because of hard-heartedness? Are they overwhelmed with the freedom that comes from being healed? Are they oblivious? They approach Jesus as divine, knowing he has some kind of power to help them. What if sometimes we neglect to say thank you, to open up to Jesus because we're afraid? Afraid of crying, afraid of going back emotionally to a place where it was painful, afraid of facing God? What if God actually would require something of us that we have to give? What if it's just all too much? Today, let us simply not be grateful for the sake of being grateful. Let us not give thanks because it's required of us in this holiday time. Instead, may we stop in our tracks and look at the one who brings goodness and hope to us. The God who has healed us and redeemed us and sustained us and fulfilled us, who gives us life again and again and again. In this time of worship, let's go to Jesus in praise as we recognize his sovereign hand over our lives individually and as a community of faith. Because the truth is, we're just like these lepers. We come diseased, broken, and pleading. We come isolated, lost, at the end of our own strength. We come tired of a world that can't offer us what we most need. And we cry out, Jesus, have mercy on us, Jesus, please. And when he does, show us his mercy. Let us not take the good fortune that we have been given and simply move on to the next thing in our lives. Let us take a moment with the Lord in praise and thanksgiving and humble adoration. The Lord has been so merciful to us in this very, very challenging and depressing season of life. And just as we have sought the Lord's mercy together, let us be people who stop and give him thanks and praise together. Amen.
Each year at Free Methodist around Thanksgiving time, we sing a hymn called Come Ye Thankful People Come. And before we sing it today for our last hymn, I wanted to remind you that this song, which is full of language about harvest and talks about corn and grain and gathering it in before the winter storms, I wanted to remind you that it's not just talking about agricultural communities, but no, it's talking about God's harvest, which applies to all of us. For the good news of that Jesus came to bring, that God loves you, and that Jesus died for you, and through that we have the opportunity to be made new and to be made ready for God's harvest, where he will bring his his people, his children, home to his good kingdom. So as we're singing about the corn and the grain being gathered in, recognize that that's talking about you and I being made right with God through Jesus. And not only you and I, but our friends and neighbors and those around us. In John 4, Jesus said to his disciples, "Open your eyes and look. Look at the fields. They are ripe for harvest." Teaching them that the people around them were ready for this good news that he had to bring, and ready for the gift that he would bring them, bring us, his death and resurrection. So let's sing about God's harvest.
Jesus gives us our closing words today as we leave our time of worship. Just as he blessed the man who said thank you, so he blesses us today with these words. Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well. So we get up, rejoicing in the Lord our Savior. Get up and go with peace, with true gratefulness in your heart, for knowing God and walking with him each day. Go in the Lord Jesus. Amen.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hands have made,
I see the stars. I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great.
Fill my heart, then I shall bow.